Hello and welcome to my channel. In this video I am showing you how I painted this whimsical hare landscape with acrylic inks. You will see me making lots of mistakes and trying to correct them. If you want to have a go at this painting, you will need a pencil and a rubber like this kneading eraser, washi tape for taping the paper, this will give it a nice clean edge. For the whiskers I am using a 0.8 jelly roll pen and for the black outline a waterproof 0.7 marker. You will also need a selection of watercolor brushes in different sizes. You will need two glasses of water, one for cleaning the paints in between and the other one for having clean water for wet and wet washes. And you will need a paper towel or a rag. You will also need acrylic inks. I'm using the following colors: antelope brown, indigo, Prussian blue, Rowney blue, phthalo green, deep purple and cadmium yellow. For the snow you can use white gouache or Dr. P.H. Martin's bleed-proof white. You will also need some bulldog clips to hold the paper together if you use a pad. I am using this cold-pressed Fabriano paper pad. If you want to experiment with masking fluid, you can use this too. I won't use it in this video though. Before we get started, I wanted to show you the first practice paintings I made with my hares to show you how different the inks look on different paper. The first one is painted on Jackson's own brand watercolor paper, which is cold pressed, while this one here was painted on Bockingford paper, also cold pressed. Before you sketch out your hares and landscape, practice your hares. Look for hare images or choose a different animal such as a wolf. I like hares, so I chose them. I will probably paint another one with a cat. Once you have drawn your sketch, try to lift off some of the lead just enough so you can still see the outline. I'm starting with a small brush and paint the hares with antelope brown first. You can start with the sky first, which I have done with my first effort, but I prefer to start with the hares first. If you have never painted with acrylic inks before, you will quickly notice that they work similar to watercolors with one big difference. Once the paint is dry, you can't lift it off the paper with water. The advantage is that if you get water on the dry paint, it doesn't matter, but if you make a mistake, it's harder to correct. If you don't have inks, try watercolors instead. I like the inks because they are very intense. I keep painting over the hairs until I am happy with the coverage. Next, I am painting the hills with Prussian blue. I let it dry first before I continue with the foreground in indigo. I have sped this up a little, as it's not super interesting to watch. Plus, I messed up with my camera angle. Sorry! I wanted the foreground nice and dark. If you don't have indigo or don't like the color, try to mix blue and black. In the next step, I am painting the sky. For this I am using cadmium yellow, phthalo green, rowney blue and deep purple. I wet the paper first where I want the colors to go. I'm not sure if you can see this, but I have a lot of fluff on my paper, which I'm trying to get rid of, as I don't really want to paint over that. I ended up using a different brush to add more water. Make sure you don't add too much water on the paper, or otherwise you end up with a lot of puddles. I'm adding yellow first, followed by blue and green, filling the whole background. I leave the purple until last and make sure it does not mix with any yellow. If you have never tried mixing purple and yellow, it results in a really ugly muddy brown. I add the purple to the horizon line just under the blue. Unfortunately, the battery of one of my lights died, so I had to turn off the recording briefly and change the battery. Always have a spare battery when filming. I let the painting dry, and while letting it dry, I have added another layer of Prussian blue to the hills, a step I later regretted. To speed up the drying, use a hairdryer. I didn't like how the sky looked and decided to add another layer of paint. I have sped this up for you. After this was dry, I noticed a big blue blob on my hair. I tried to lift it with my knife, which was not such a good idea, and then added another layer of brown. I didn't like how the hills were as dark as the foreground, so I decided to add snow by using Dr. P.H. Martin's bleed-proof white. I also added snow by splattering the white using two different sized brushes. Once the painting was dry, I added a black outline to the hairs. I then added whiskers with a white jelly roll pen. And now comes the satisfying part of peeling off the washi tape. The painting doesn't quite look as I had planned, but I think I managed to rescue it. And now I better wash all my brushes. I hope you liked this video and will have a go at creating your own painting. If you have a question, please feel free to leave a comment. And if you want to support this channel, you can do so by liking, sharing and subscribing. You can also donate via PayPal. The link is in the description. Thank you for watching. Happy painting. Until next time.